Welcome to Ballard Church Online. I'm Brandon.
I'm Christiana.
And man, we are excited this season to kind of engage this way virtually. We're together, we're still here. Ballard Church community lives on. And man, we're really excited really to have this opportunity to kind of still grow, find and follow Jesus, even in the midst of everything going on in our city. And so if you're new to Ballard Church, we'd love to start every single service off with prayer. And so if you're comfortable with it, go ahead and bow your heads wherever you're at. We're gonna pray for service today. Jesus, we thank you so much for who you are. God, we pray, Lord, that in this season, Jesus, you'd bring peace. You would help us just continue to just gather together in our communities, Jesus, just helping bring your love and your light into a city that needs it so badly right now, Jesus. Would your peace reign in Ballard, in King County, and in our city, in Jesus' name. Come on, everybody said.
Amen.
Amen. Come on. Well, I'm excited to be here.
Yes.
We do have a few different things that we want to cover, a few different announcements. We have a really cool thing happening every single Wednesday night from this point forward. Yes. Christiana, tell us about Wednesdays.
We are really looking forward to Wednesdays. So every Wednesday night at 7, we're going to be going live on Instagram and Facebook, and it's just going to be like a virtual hangout. Mm-hmm. You can wear pajamas, you can be comfortable, but we're going to be going through just some fun things that we've got planned. Yeah. It's going to be a little bit different every week. So we're going to have panel discussions. We'll have some Q&As, yep. Questions that need answers. Answering.
Yes.
We're going to be doing, Brandon will talk more about it, but we're going to be doing a daily devotional, so answering your questions. Mm-hmm. But the biggest thing is show up live. You can answer right. questions live, or mm-hmm. if you can't come, you could submit them at info@ballardchurch.com. But we're just really looking forward to it.
It's true. Please submit your questions. It's going to be an awesome season. If you got the email from Ballard Church, you know why. You need to submit your questions. But hey, like Christiana mentioned, we are excited to jump into our new Bible read-through starting tomorrow. We're going to start our week off right on Monday in the book of Proverbs. So for the next 31 days, we're going to be reading scripture together, and it's one of my favorite books because it's practical, it's spiritual, there's a lot of different things going on, but they're bite-sized, and I love nothing better than bite-sized snacks. And so please jump in with us for the next 31 days, get into scripture, talk about it with your friends, tune in Wednesday night for our 7 p.m. panel discussions, and Ballard Church, let's just have an incredible season as we engage online.
Hey everyone, in just a moment, we're gonna get to Lance's message. But before we do that, we wanted to talk to you about the daily devotions that we're doing here as a church. Now more than ever, we think it is so important that we get into our Bible every day, which is why we're going to be reading a chapter of Proverbs every day for the next 31 days. But maybe that's new to you. Maybe you've never opened your Bible before, you haven't done it in a while. We just wanted to tell you the best method that we have found to get into your Bible every day, and that's the SOAP method. SOAP stands for Scripture, Observation, Application, Prayer. First up is Scripture. Every day when you're reading your proverb, we feel like a line is going to stand out to you, or maybe even a whole verse. And when that happens, the best thing to do is just write it in your journal. We feel like writing that down is going to help you remember it, but most importantly, apply it. Next up is observation. You just wrote down that scripture or that verse that really stood out to you, but why? What do you feel like it means for you? What do you feel like it means for your life? Or maybe even what do you feel like God is saying to you right now? Grab your journal, write down some observations, just things you feel like you got from that scripture. Once we finish the observation section in your journal, the next section is application, and it's just like what it sounds like. How do we take those things that you learned and apply them to your everyday life? Maybe it's your work, your friendships, your family. Wherever it applies to you, look through that observation section and maybe pick one or two that you feel like you could use to apply to your everyday life. And lastly is prayer. We've identified those 1 to 2 applications that we want to make in our lives, but we can't do this on our own. We have to invite God into the process. Maybe that's something that you do out loud or quietly to yourself, but you could also put it in your journal and write down your prayers. And that's the SOAP method: scripture, observation, application, prayer. There's tons of ways to get going reading your Bible, but we hope this one works for you. If you have any questions, you can email info@ballardchurch.com. And now we're going to continue our Sunday service with a message from Lance.
Well, hey, Ballard Church, I'm so glad you jumped into this experience this Sunday. I know this is not how we expected to meet, but it might look like the reality for a little bit longer. And I'm so grateful for technology so we can connect this way still, dive into God's word. And listen, if you're at home right now and doing church at home and you are not in sweats and with coffee, you are definitely doing this wrong. So go ahead and pause it and get comfortable. And I'm so excited for the fact that we still get to hang out on a Sunday, even amidst crazy and uncertain, pretty unprecedented times. And so I just wanna encourage you for a second, if you're feeling anxiety or fear, or maybe you're nervous about what's coming up and what's around the corner because every day news seems to be escalating, you're not alone. And it doesn't mean you have a lack of faith, and it doesn't mean that you're a bad person or a terrible follower of Jesus. It's a natural response. The good news that we have, though, is that God actually speaks to crisis. God speaks to what happens in the midst of uncertain times. When the church was just starting, we see after Jesus' death and resurrection, the church began to explode, but it was hostile territory to be a follower of Jesus. And so letters were written to different followers in different regions as they were experiencing questions, as they were experiencing persecution. One happened, actually, it's the book of Hebrews that we're going to be talking through a little bit today. Emperor Nero was the emperor of Rome, and he was persecuting Christians left and right. And so they're in a place where they don't know what's coming up next, where they're asking a lot of very real questions. And as we dive into Hebrews, I think we can be encouraged of how do we respond in a God-focused way to the craziness that's happening around us. So why don't we dive in? I know you don't have any March Madness to tune into. You don't have any NBA to turn into, anything. So this is our option right now. Why don't we dive in? Hebrews chapter 10, verse 22 is where we're going to kick off. Here's what it says. Let us draw near to God with a sincere heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled and cleansed of us from any guilty conscience, and having our bodies washed with pure water. This is important in verse 23. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope that we profess. And for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how we might spur one another on towards love and good deeds. Let us not give up meeting together, which I know is difficult right now, but we'll get there, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. I think when we read a passage like that, it can be easy to jump through quickly, but let's dive in, and what we find is three really practical, easy things that we can do during a season like this to hold on to our faith a little bit tighter. The first one, and maybe your first point, if you're taking notes, the first thing we can do to find encouragement in the midst of crisis is simply to draw near to God. In verse 22, we saw it said pretty clearly. Here's what it says. Let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with a full assurance that faith brings. That's actually a phrase, let us draw near to God, that the author of Hebrews writes four times because he realizes who the audience is. Kind of throughout this book, chapter by chapter, he sprinkles in the idea, hey, don't forget, draw near to God. And the reason he does that is because he knows that we can be confident when we draw near to God, he is faithful to draw near to us as well. That when we do that, something begins to happen in us that is unlike anything else. What I've seen maybe throughout the Bible, and maybe you've even felt in your own life, is that when God does something in us, typically he's preparing to do something through us. And in this coming season, maybe this is just the beginning, and these tense times are fertile soil for God to plant something significant that we're gonna see miracles happen later. We're gonna see the church step up and be the hope of the world, the light of the world, in a time that it really, really needs it. One practical way that we're hoping to implement that you can draw near to God, as we kind of do it collectively as a church, even though we can't meet corporately, is to invest in your personal faith. An easy way to do that is to lean into your Bible. There's something significant that happens in God's word. And if you've never had the chance to maybe make this a practical personal discipline in your life, this is your moment to do it. And it won't be scary. It won't be intimidating. It's really pretty simple. And I realize your schedules are busy. You have a lot going on. But here's what we're going to do. Starting on Monday, March 16th, we're going to start reading together through the book of Proverbs. Now, maybe you've never opened up the Bible before, but the book of Proverbs is amazing. You can find an app. You can get your Bible. If you have a physical one, maybe you need to dust it off a shelf, or maybe this is something you do daily anyway, and you can adjust it. And as a church, we're going to start one chapter a day, starting chapter one. Feels like an easy place to start. In Proverbs, there's 31 chapters. So as we read through a chapter a day, I believe God's going to implant wisdom into us. And I would challenge you, starting on Monday, jump in with that. Because when God starts to work in you, it's amazing what he can do through you. Things start to change. And really, I believe we're going to see some incredible fruit from it. The second point that I want you to know is not just to draw near to God, but the second one is this, to hold fast to hope. hold fast to hope. It says this in verse 23, let us hold unswervingly, what an incredible SAT word, let us hold unswervingly to the hope that we profess, for he who promised is faithful. When I hear the word unswervingly to hope, it just simply means let me stay focused. And let me just be real with you, I'm not a very focused person. I can't keep my attention very well on one thing. I don't stick with diets very well. I don't do any of that. I just can't keep focused. It reminds me of, I don't know if you've ever seen little kids play sports before. Maybe you've seen them play like little kids soccer. It is amazing to watch because they cannot keep focused for anything. Like there's always, I feel bad for the kid who's stuck playing goalie at a little kid soccer game because inevitably they're sitting down picking grass after like 5 minutes because they can't stay focused on something that isn't in front of them. I think in a time where there will always be another news article that you can read, there's always gonna be a new special on Netflix, there's always gonna be some crazy and chaotic thing happening with your kids running around, I would challenge you to fix your eyes and stay focused on the opportunity that we have, to stay focused on how you are drawing near to God, to stay focused on the promises that he's put forth to us. Because remember, as the verse says, he is faithful. And if you're looking for maybe a dangerous prayer to pray, because you never know what could happen when you pray something like this, maybe a prayer for you would be, God, would you rid me of excuses so I can draw near to you? Would you rid me of excuses to help keep me focused? In this season, what would that look like? Maybe it's setting aside the slew of emails that I know you're getting. Maybe it's just taking 5 minutes, maybe after you read in Proverbs, and saying, God, what would you want to speak to me? Because I want to hold fast to what you're saying. More than anything else, more than any other news outlet, God, what are you speaking and how can I be encouraged? Point number three is gonna be encourage the people around you. In a time where everybody has something to say and everyone has an opinion, it's just crazy the things that we've seen on social media, crazy the things that you've seen on Facebook lately, the lines that are at Costco right now. There's so many questions that come up, but how can we be a voice of encouragement in so much skepticism? How can we be a voice of encouragement when so many people feel fear? It can be really hard to do, but here's again what it says in Hebrews. Let us consider how we may spur one another toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another. And all the more as you see the day approaching. This week I was on Facebook and I usually try and avoid it, but you know what, amidst everything, I was on Facebook and all the articles, all the studies, all the facts, I saw one post that a gal posted. She said, hey, I have extra baby wipes at my house. I don't have a lot, but I think I could spare an extra pack. If somebody needs it, go ahead and let me know. I'd love to bring it to your house. And man, amidst everything that's going on, what a practical way to show hope to the world and be generous. I don't know what that looks like for you. Maybe it just means picking up your phone and texting somebody. Texting someone who has kids at home that they're trying to figure out what they're gonna do with their career as they're now homeschooled parents. Maybe they're a principal of a school they never wanted to be at. And maybe you can encourage them and say, I know this is a hard time, can I bring lunch today? Maybe it's just an encouraging text to say, I realize things might be scary right now, but God's got us and I can encourage you that way. I don't know what it looks like for you, but I would challenge you, how do we be hopeful in a season where so many people are skeptical? A great theologian and a Christian thinker, his name was A.W. Tozer, he said this that I thought was so fitting for a season like this. A scared world needs a fearless church. A scared world needs a fearless church. And maybe you don't feel like you're a part of a church because you're isolated and by yourself, but the greatest thing that we see in scripture is that Jesus was not just about gathering people together, but encouraging people personally to be the church. That where you are at your house is where God chooses to be. That God says he will meet you exactly where you're at if you choose to draw near, to stay focused. Maybe today, as we conclude, maybe today the first person that you need to encourage is yourself. That you're gonna be okay, that you can do it, that you can hold strong, that you can set aside fear, and that there are options at the table. So today I just wanna pray for us as we close up, and I believe that God really can meet us, and he is faithful to meet us in a time of crisis. Let's pray. God, thank you that you show up. Thank you that in this season where there's so many question marks, you are still at work. And even though we don't have the perspective maybe to see it yet, I pray that as we maybe look back one day on this, we realize you were working in us to prepare to do something through us. As a church, even though we can't meet together, would you sharpen us personally? Throughout the story of your son Jesus, we see him willfully go into isolation and the fruit of it be absolutely incredible. So would you do the same thing for us? Would you capitalize on this season not to be something that we simply get through, but something that you work through? We're thankful, we're thankful, we're thankful. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you guys.
Hey, thank you for joining us at Valor Church Online. We're so excited you were encouraged by today's message. Remember, submit your questions for Wednesday nights either by emailing info@valorchurch.com or sending them over on social media. Besides that, we'll see you guys and hopefully you'll tune in next week.